Hello all, in this particular video, we'll be constructing the circuit for the three gates, that is the derived gates called as NAND gate, NOR gate and your XOR gate. First, we shall try to take up your NOR gate. See, as you could see the diagram in the NOR gate, my pin number changes. Your first pin acts as your output pin, second and third pin acts as your input pin. As you could see the circuit diagram here, you can just visualize that second and third acts as your input and first acts as your output, fourth acts as your output, 5 and 6 acts as your input, and 9 and 8 is your input, 10 is your output, 11, 12 is your input and 13 is your output. The remaining thing is same, that a 7th pin is connected to your ground and 14th pin is connected to your power supply or VCC. Now we shall try to construct the gate. My IC number for your NOR gate is 7402. I have the IC and I have placed my IC in the IC slot. Lock the IC, then we shall try start connecting the circuit. My first pin is your output pin. Next, my second pin acts as one of the input pin and third pin acts as my second input. Okay, 7th pin is connected to ground and 14th pin is connected to power supply. Now your circuit has been connected. I'll switch on the circuit, check for the output. When both the cases, see, observe the truth table. See, my for NOR gate, when both the cases are 0, the output is 1. For rest all other cases, it is 0 or low. Now, coming to the circuit, when my both the cases are low or 0, my output is high or 1. For any other possible combination, that is for 0, 1, it is still low. For 1, 0, it is low. And for 1, 1, it is still low. So, this is all about your NAND gate.
NOR gate.
Next, we shall try to take up your NAND gate. Next, we shall take up NOR gate. See, the IC number associated with NAND gate is 7400. I have the circuit diagram. See, in circuit diagram for NAND gate, your first pin acts as input, 1 and 2 acts as input, and third pin acts as output. The truth table says that when both the inputs are high, your output will be low. Okay, as per the pin diagram, it is same, 1 and 2 acts as input, third pin acts as output. So first pin is connected to my input 1, second pin is connected to input 2, third pin is connected to your output. Okay, so as per your truth table, when first we shall your 7th and 14th pin is grounded and it is 14th pin is connected to your power supply. We'll check for the output now. As per the truth table, when both the inputs are low, it is high. Next, when it is 0 and 1, it is high. When it is 1, 0, it is high. When both the inputs are low, when both the inputs are high, the output will be low. So this is all about your NAND gate. The very next gate is your XOR gate. The IC number associated with XOR gate is 7486. I have taken the IC and I have inserted the IC already and I have made the proper connection. So we shall try to take up the circuit diagram. See, this is the representation of your circuit diagram. So the truth table says that for both the inputs are low, your output will be low. And for both the inputs are high, my output is low. Rest all other condition, your output signal will be high. As per your pin configuration, it is 7486 pin configuration is goes like this. 1 and 2 acts as your input and 3rd acts as your output. 4th and 5th acts as your input, 6th as your output, 7th is ground and 14th is power supply. We shall check for the output. When my both the conditions are 0, your output is 0. When it is 0 and 1, it is 1. When it is 1, 0, it is 1. When it is 1, 1, your output is 0 or low. So this is all about your XOR gate. In the next video, we shall try to take up the realization of derived gates using basic gates. Thank you.